Ladies and gentlemen, if I may have your attention, our program is about to begin. It is my honor to introduce to you our keynote speaker of the evening. He is a prominent businessman in Samoa and abroad. He is the Minister of Commerce, Industry and Labor, as well as the Minister of Tourism. He is the chairman of the Mr. Wheeler 2005. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage the Honorable Minister Hans Joachim Keil.
For coming this evening to support the Mr. Wheeler pageant, we hope you will all have an enjoyable time. Fafitai mai soi fua.
Fafitai lava, Honorable Minister, for your address this evening. And now,
hello, Dante. How are you this evening?
I am fine. I'm a bit nervous, but I'm good.
Well, don't you worry.
Talofalava, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. It's a pleasure to have you here tonight, and I hope you're enjoying yourself. As you all know, we're all here to witness the 12 beautiful contestants and to find out who will be crowned Mr. Wheeler 2005.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's get this show rolling. I bet they can't wait to see the girls. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage for the introductory number. I give to you the current Miss Samoa and the 12 contestants for the Mr. Wheeler 2005. What about a big round of applause for these lovely ladies? kwa tele na mwotazo chuma chacha vao ne vyafi. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our graceful beauties vying for the title of Mr. Wheeler tonight, with their opening performance led by our current Miss Samoa, Saifalu Polu, and Forsyth Fata Masese. And their opening number was choreographed by Kevin Schuster to music sung by none other than Adante herself.
Thank you, Dan. You know, Dan, the media over the Tawila festivities have been very supportive of tonight's event in promoting and profiling each contestant as they went about their activities throughout the 2 weeks they have been together. But tonight, we're going to learn more about these beautiful young ladies.
And ladies and gentlemen, we'll now bring back on stage our contestants one by one to introduce themselves to us all this evening. And first up, contestant number one. A big round of applause for contestant number one. It's a patch patch by Montage of Tatsala or Mual Nefiafi.
Talo Falava Samoa, Iawa Mauta Simanu, Esifulvalo Tausanga. O te saumai nea lala whanga o sa whātou e le whanga, ma o te fia fia whalau ilo atu, lo lango lango ina au, e le company o le whala pula. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Lamauta Simanu, I'm 18 years old, and I'm from the village of sa whātou e le whanga, and I am honored to be sponsored by the Pineapple Enterprises.
Pineapple Enterprises is currently pursuing her Bachelor of Arts degree at the National University of Samoa. Her goal is to enter law school. Apart from her academic responsibilities, she enjoys teaching at Sunday school and singing in the church choir. Ladies and gentlemen, a hand for Miss Lamauta Simanu representing Pineapple Enterprises.
Let's bring on stage contestant number two.
Ualua Sifulua o Tausanga. O Lo'o Lango Lango Ina A'u o Dominguez Church of Southern California. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Valerie Sina Kelsall. I am 20 years of age and I am proudly sponsored by Dominguez Church of Southern California.
Valerie Sina Kelsall is the first Miss Samoa representing the community in Southern California. As a half-caste Samoan, she finds the opportunity to come to Samoa, not only an exciting experience, but to learn more of our culture so she can educate the world, especially the people in her community in Southern California. Meanwhile, she is pursuing a Bachelor of Nursing degree. Miss Southern California, ladies and gentlemen.
And now let's welcome on stage contestant number three.
Upele Samoa, Olo Uingoa, O Maria Easter Tuumalo Yowelu, Elua Sefulu Tasia Utausanga, Malo Olangolango Minau, Ele Samoan Heritage Board of Utah. My beautiful island of Samoa, my name is Maria Easter Tuumalo Yowelu. I am 21 years old and I am proudly sponsored by the Samoan Heritage Board of Utah.
Representing the community in Utah, Maria's passion is working with non-profit organizations that value young people's future by holding educational workshops, community service, and sports events. At the same time, she studies communication at the University of Utah, as she believes education is an investment that brings great rewards. Thank you, Maria Yuelu, Miss Samoa, Utah.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage contestant number four.
Honorable judges, Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, ta lofa lava. My name is Berthadine Faiupukeki and I'm 26 years old. I am Miss Samoa Australia and I'm proudly sponsored by Travel Scene at Scene World Travel Australia. Fafitai lava.
Berthadine, or Dini as she is known amongst family and friends, is a teacher to grade 5 students at Education Queensland Australia. As a young lady and role model, she enjoys dancing, coaching and playing netball, as well as reading and hanging out with friends. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Samoa Australia Brisbane, Berthadine Faiupukeki.
And please welcome contestant number 5.
Talofa lava lepa ia malema malu o poto poto mai le nei po o lo ingoa o Jennifer tava etoto tafi e lua sefulu o tausanga a lo olanga langoina o ele McDonald's Family Restaurant of Samoa. Talofa and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jennifer tava etoto tafi. I am 20 years old and I'm proudly being sponsored by the one and only McDonald's Family Restaurant of Samoa.
Jennifer Tava'etoto Tafi carries with her leadership qualities acquired in her roles as class captain and student body president. She is an avid sports player, a committed student too in her pursuit of a bachelor degree in sociology, majoring in criminal justice at the University of Utah. Her leisure activities include singing, dancing and choreographing hip-hop and Polynesian dancing. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss McDonald's Family Restaurant.
Please welcome on stage contestant number 6.
Ta lofa lava Samoa, aloingoa o Rosina Paulo, ualangolangoina o Elea Isle of Hope, my New South Wales, Sydney, Australia. Greetings, my name is Rosina Paulo. Tonight, to represent the Isle of Hope and our beautiful Samoan community from New South Wales, Sydney, Australia. Faftai.
Miss Rosina Paulo is very happy for the opportunity to use her passion for performing arts to entertain and enlighten people's lives, even if it's just for one moment. She's the managing director of an entertainment agency called Spirit of the Islands in Sydney, Australia. A hand, ladies and gentlemen, for Rosina Paulo, Miss Samoa, New South Wales.
And ladies and gentlemen, on stage at the moment is contestant number 7.
Tala falava Samoa. Olo uingo, Shirley Tutui Fau. Elusu Tasio Tosanga, Olangolongina, Ule Jonita Tours of Samoa. Greetings and welcome to all of the ladies and gentlemen of our audience tonight. You all look beautiful, by the way. My name is Shirley Tutui Fau. I'm 21 years old from Malua, and I'm proudly blessed to represent Jonita Tours of Samoa.
Miss Jonita Tours is a young lady with many talents, some of which include being a music teacher to 8 students, a choir director, and an aspiring music composer. Her strong belief is that the future of tomorrow lies in the hands of the leaders of today. Faftai Shirley Tatu'utuifau, Miss Jonita Tours.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome on stage contestant number 8.
My name is Naura Curry, and I'm proudly sponsored by Weddies of Samoa.
Well, we may have a future doctor in Miss Weddings of Samoa as she pursues this goal at the University of the South Pacific, undertaking preliminary science. The Miss Te Wila pageant is an opportunity for her to reflect the teachings of her family that has helped her realize how a real Samoan girl should be. Above all, she values the Samoan way of life and her people. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Weddings of Samoa, Nelda Curry.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage contestant number 9.
Samoa, iau tau paia ma o tau pamalu wa fia mai le nei po. Wa'o o fusina to amua, wa luasful matasi e nei au tau sanga, ma ua langolango ina au e ma o lesi Samoa. Greetings, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am so honored and very happy to be part of this Miss Samoa pageant, portraying the theme Samoa, the pride of Polynesia. I am your happy contestant number 9, proudly sponsored by Moalesi Samoa Limited.
Ofusina Toamua is a person that loves to try new things, and the Miss Te Wila pageant is certainly one of them. Her upbringing consists of climbing trees, playing lape, hide and seek, and other aspects of life Samoan ladies are used to. She is a graduate of Martin Horter's Institute in New Zealand and a former student of the National University Preparatory. Faftai Ofusina Toamua, Miss Moalesi, ladies and gentlemen.
And ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome on stage contestant number 10.
Talofa Samoa, e tū manu ai lilia, I le paia ma le mamalu oe e tainei le maota. O lo'u ingoa o Marilina Sasebe, lua sepulu tolua o tausanga. Ma lo'u fa'a alo alo lava, wa o le sui tau vā o tangata anu o Samoa I Niusila. Ma o lenei pō, o au o lo'u tausala numera sepulu. Greetings from the land of the long white cloud. My name is Marilina Sasebe, 23 years of age. I am humbled to be the representative of the Samoan community in Aotearoa, New Zealand. And this evening, I'm your contestant number 10, Papatei Lava.
Representing the Samoan community in New Zealand, Marilina Sasebe is using the opportunity to explore her cultural heritage as a Samoan tamaitai. She brings along with her personality her love of music, singing, reading, and socializing. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Samoa, New Zealand.
Please welcome on stage contestant number 11.
Pa ia mal mamalu a fia mai le nei po o lo ingo fa lutse salvao sio vauli malo lango lango ina o le Federal Pacific Insurance. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Falute Salvao Sio Vauli, and I'm honored to be representing Federal Pacific Insurance, the best insurance company you can trust.
Valuta believes that being part of the Miss Te Wila pageant is an important stepping stone for her as she supports this ongoing development which strives to preserve and sustain the essence of a true Samoan lady within the South Pacific. Her education reflects her career path as she is employed as an administrative and accounts officer while in her final semester completing a Bachelor of Commerce degree majoring in accounting. Thank you, Miss Federal Pacific Insurance Limited.
And our final contestant for this evening, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage contestant number 12.
Malo. welcome. My name is Sally King. I'm 24 years old, and I'm proudly sponsored by ANZ. The better we know you, the more we can do.
Ms. Sally King feels that all it takes for women is courage to overcome challenges they may face. She enters this pageant with hopes that it will change the traditional mentality that pageants are not just about beauty, but intelligence, grace, and a promoter of her rich heritage and culture. Sally King, ladies and gentlemen, representing ANZ.
Well, Andante, I can safely say that this year's pageant has exceeded our expectation, given the fact that the number of participants has increased tremendously compared to previous years. And the full support of our Samoan community overseas have been endorsed by their representatives competing in this evening's pageant.
And talk about competing, naturally tonight's contestants, whether represented by local and overseas businesses and communities, will be judged in various categories to find the overall winner or Miss Tewila for 2005. And we're pleased to announce that in our midst are very courageous and outstanding people of our community who have been invited to be judges for tonight's event.
And ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor of introducing our main judge. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you are being a great audience this evening, and I know that you can't wait for the girls to come back on stage and show off their traditional attires. Before we do that, I would like to present to you some very special guests for our entertainment this evening. And Andante, would you like to introduce our entertainers?
Prof. Tidan, ladies and gentlemen, all the way from the land of the long white cloud, Sir Howard Morrison and Tamero New Zealand Māori Group.
Venerable judges, good evening. Give me a smile, please.
Quando canyon tereso, akin a flyer. Love me with all of your heart, as I love you. Just promise me this, that you'll give me all of your kisses. Every winter, every summer, every fall. When we are far apart, or when you're near. All of your heart, as I love you. Don't give me your love for a moment or an hour. Love me always as you've loved me from the start. With every beat of your heart. The Pearls, Vicky Lee and Cindy Joe, all the way from Palmerston North, New Zealand.
Love me with all of your heart, as I love you.
Don't give me your love for a moment or an hour. Love me always as you've loved me from the start. When we are far apart, or when we're near me, love me with all of your heart, as I love you. Just give me a moment or an hour. love you always as you've loved me from the start, with every beat of your heart.
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what about another big round of applause for Sir Howard Morrison? And ladies and gentlemen, we will now move on to the first appearance or the first category for this evening, and that is traditional wear. Please put your hands together and welcome on stage contestant number one, Miss Pineapple Enterprises.
The contribution of the Mo'ota of a high chief to the uniqueness of the Samoan culture as the pride of Polynesia. La Mo'ota is wearing a traditional wear that dictates and honors her cultural heritage. The grand palace of a Samoan high chief is the centerpiece of the Samoan culture. It is used for gathering of village councils, meeting place for families, and a place where visitors are welcomed and where young Samoans learn the custom and culture. The skirt of her traditional wear is the Samoan fale, made out of dalauba. The thatch of the fale is made out of coconut leaves. The blinds are made out of the lawa'a of the coconut tree. Posts and foundation of the fale are all done with black and brown dyed afa or sinnet. For any important occasion, the taupo or the high chief's daughter performs the ava ceremony, which is first done to seek the god's blessings for a peaceful conclusion to the gathering. The taupo outfit is done with black and brown afa or sinnet, enhanced with lopa shined in coconut oil to give the outfit an astounding look. Her headpiece is also done with afa to replace the traditional tuinga by the taupo to give it a more modernized look. With all these attributes, La Mo'ota is proud to display her traditional wear designed and put together by Gardenia Hinano Boutique.
Enterprises. Please welcome on stage contestant number two, Miss Samoa, Southern California.
Valerie's gown depicts her Samoan culture from the past and into the future. The gown is comprised of the many homegrown natural resources found only in Samoa. Her gown is of natural colors, being mostly black and brown. The color of silver is a reminder to us all of how we have advanced. The natural brown on her gown is mostly the afa from the coconut tree, which is woven into many artifacts of the Samoan culture, such as their fales and as a fue during chiefs or matai meetings. Valerie calls your attention to the silver colored hearts along the stretch, cut out from the coconut husk as well. It depicts the heart of the Samoan people being generous and most loving in all of Polynesia. Along with the afa, you will find on Valerie's gown the ua, which is stripped off the bark of a mulberry tree. Valerie then releases the skirt part of her gown and reveals her natural beauty in a one-piece suit of Samoa's precious attire. Her skirt is made of black linen fabric, again accentuated by the afa and the ua. Her skirt can be worn as a cloak to keep warm or while nursing in the dark ages. The black linen fabric, of course, represents the dark ages in Samoa before Christianity arrived. The silver colorings on her gown also represent the light in Samoa following the dark ages. Our people are indeed the most happiest of all people, therefore earning them the title of the Heart of Polynesia. To complete her traditional gown, Valerie is wearing a headdress called tuwinga, decorated and covered by the Ua and Afa. The tuwinga is one of Samoa's most prized possessions, worn only by a young lady with high regards or a daughter of a chief.
Thank you, Miss Samoa, Southern California. Please welcome on stage Miss Samoa, Utah, Maria Esther Tumaloyuelu.
This contemporary traditional wear is designed and styled to suit Maria Esther and the theme of this year's pageant, Samoa, the Pride of Polynesia. Her gown is made entirely from plain, unprinted tapa cloth or ua. The designs applied on the hem represents waves breaking on the shores, while the diamond motifs represents the typical original siapo design of Samoa. As filler, ha'a is applied in the diamond motifs to bring out its exquisite look. The back train of the gown has wood roses, ba'utu'utu reeds, and coconut ribbing applied at the bow. To complement her outfit, a necklace, also fashioned out of ua cloth, with rooster feathers of burnt orange and black, is sewn on it as a bright finishing. It is most appropriate to wear at a formal evening cocktail or a bridal wear. We present Miss Samoa, Utah, lovingly designed and put together by her family in Apia.
Thank you, Miss Samoa, Utah. Please welcome on stage contestant number 4, Miss Samoa, Australia, from.
Has been made using hessian, shawls and afa, all natural materials from the islands. The colors you see on the tiputa are hundreds of tiny seashells dyed to display the jewel-like beauty of the Pacific. The tiputa signifies the strong and courageous character that our women display on the outward. Underneath this exterior, she hides an astounding depth of beauty, which is captured in the dress Dini wears underneath. Dini's strapless hessian dress has been cut to her figure. The top is embellished with vibrant red feathers, which descend into hundreds of tiny seashells reminiscent of the waterfalls of Samoa. Notice the rings of coconut shells carefully set into the hessian material. This was chosen to display the humility and simplicity of Samoa. The dress descends down to a slight gathering at the bottom, and the back is encrusted with seashells that leads into a red feather tail. This beautiful ensemble was designed and created by Dini and her mother, Kelly Hooch of Kelly Creations.
Thank you, Miss Samoa, Australia from Brisbane. Please welcome on stage contestant number 5, Miss McDonald's Family Restaurant.
Only in Samoa, there is a Samoan way of doing anything which is known as the Fa'a Samoa. Our fundamental qualities, cultural beliefs, and environment are all underpinned by this distinct feature of the Fa'a Samoa. One of these features is the Ava ceremony, or the traditional welcoming ritual, often performed in the midst of high chiefs and their visiting guests, together with untitled men and a taupo to prepare and serve the Ava drink. Miss McDonald is modeling the main components for the Ava ceremony, all constructed from the natural materials in our environment. The base of the garment is made of the mulberry fiber, or laua, and is dyed with the natural black color, lama. Around her waist is a replica of a tanoa, or ava bowl, which is used to mix the ceremonial ava. And to partake of this drink, there is the ipupopo, or coconut cup, which adorns her hair and complements the whole design. These two represent our people's respect, friendship, and cordial mannerisms. For her top is a model of the fue, which accompanies the to'oto'o and completes her stance. This pair represents our unique language, which we have maintained over the years. This was our only means of record keeping, thus our ancestors through word of mouth have been able to sustain our language and identity. Despite the influences of modernization, Samoa, through its rich language, has preserved for centuries its culture and lifestyles, which is so appealing to inquisitive cultural seekers from around the globe. Samoa is truly the envy of Polynesia, as we have maintained our peaceful heritage over thousands of years. A beautiful creation by Ruby Taituuma.
Thank you, Ms. McDonald's Family Restaurant. Please welcome on stage contestant number 6, Ms. Samoa, New South Wales.
The life of the Samoan Tamaitai is depicted in many areas of her life. But the most unique of all is the way she upholds her title as a taupo in her family and community. Tonight, Rosina is wearing a wear that defines these aspects into details. She is portraying a ofumoemoe, one that is only worn by a daughter of a high chief. The off-white blush of the laua is a symbol of virginity, a representation of purity of a Samoan maiden. The black sinnet and coconut aile signifies the roots of her family and her heritage. The brown sinnet on her wear and is served as a hairpiece embodies the fue, symbol of wisdom and the knowledge of her family in the culture. The coconut shells corresponds to the wealth of the land and the wealth of her family. The leaf shape on her ofu symbolizes the future of her family, children. Attributes so finely depicted on her attire, she walks in the 21st century as a proud Samoan taupo who is well taught about her heritage and her culture.
Thank you, Ms. Samoa, New South Wales. Please welcome on stage contestant number 7, Ms. Jonita Tours.
By using only the main elements and original accessories used on ancient traditional wear, Shirley's traditional wear is made up of various shells, the ietonga, afa, pulumoa, and different types of sand found throughout the shores of our island. The crushed shells create an image of one of the most famous waterfalls in the Pacific, found only here in Upolu, Samoa, the cradle of Polynesia. While the Victorian-styled coat represents the arrival of the good word from the missionaries 175 years ago. It also represents the unique and diverse style the Samoan people have when it comes to designing and creating fashion with a flame.
Thank Jonita Tour. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage contestant number 8, Miss Weddings of Samoa.
One of the most famous and romantic legends that is still popular in Samoa these days is the overall theme for Miss Nelda Curry's traditional wear. It is called Sina and the Eel, or Sina and the Tuna, as it is well known. Miss Weddings of Samoa, Miss Nelda Curry, is Sina, and her outfit, as you can see, is the eel. It was one of the romantic legends ever lived where the eel fell in love with Sina and even wanted her to be his wife. Sina hated the eel so much that she even chased the eel away and said to the eel, "Kukula mai mata ulialelo." Whereas today, when you visit the island of Savai, there is a pool at Matavai Safune called Le Mata Ulialelo. After all, Sina kept hating the eel, whereas in the end, the eel died and Sina cut its head off as the eel wanted and buried it. A plant grew from it known as the coconut tree or the tree of life. So whenever Sina was thirsty, she could always drink from the fruit, and every time she drinks, she kisses the eel. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Weddings of Samoa, Miss Nelda Curry, with her traditional design by Ruby Taituruma.
Thank you, Miss Weddings of Samoa. Please welcome on stage contestant number 9, Miss Molesi Samoa Limited.
In her traditional wear, Ofusina has decided to be the whole theme. As you can see, her outfit alone is the Fale Samoa or Samoan Fale, one of the most unique aspects of our Samoan culture. In two-piece, the outside part of her garment is the tawalunga, or the roof of the fale. In place of the lau, Ofusina has used the lawa'a from the coconut tree to create the exact appearance of the Samoan fale. Ofusina then removes the outside part of her traditional wear to reveal the inside. As noted, Ofusina has ignored all the many other posts of the Samoan fale, but she has placed an emphasis on one of the most important posts stands in the middle, called the potu, or the main post. Usually, any potu is decorated with only sinets or afa in two shades, brown and black, unless the post is carved. The design of the afa is in different patterns. To make her outfit really stand out, Ofusina also prefers to use the ietonga to decorate her outfit. Her message is the importance of a potu or main post in a Samoan fale is similar to the roles, responsibilities, and values of a strong Samoan woman in any Samoan family. The entire attire is created from our own traditional Samoan fabric, the u'a, which represents the long history of Samoan attires. The u'a have been dyed in black using soot or lama.
Thank you, Ms. Molesi Samoa Limited. Please welcome on stage contestant number 10, Ms. Samoa New Zealand.
Adorned in all the dignity of the traditional tuina, the nifo'oti and her skin glowing with Samoan oil, here is Mirelina Saseve in her traditional wear, made of natural materials from Samoa and pāua shells to acknowledge her adopted home, New Zealand. Mirelina honors the cultural importance of the tuinga, recognizing the utmost respect and pride of being Samoan, her identity and whasinomanga. As the legend goes, the head of Sina's tuna developed into a new, symbolic of Mirelina's experience in this pageant. She had limited knowledge of the culture and language, but tonight, she sure has developed into a fruitful coconut tree, privileged with the Tomai Ilfa Samoa. This, to Mirelina, is only the beginning.
The Paupau sailing on the moana made of Paua shells is Marilina's tribute to her forefathers who migrated to New Zealand for a better future. She is grateful that despite living in foreign land, her family has instilled in her the importance of being Samoan. The fish tail reminds us of our sea life, our source of health and wealth. Above the fish tail is a fili made of fau and afa, which depicts the spinal cord, stating Samoan women are the backbone of society. Ma e au le ina ilawa te mai tai.
Samoan New Zealand. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage contestant number 11, Miss Federal Pacific Insurance.
A return to the formal taupo attire of Samoa. Faluta's attire is from her family heirloom of the finest of fine mats worn in a bridal fashion with a train, also formed from another fine mat. Around her waist is a red feather hipster or titi, which complements the train. Her necklace is the wild boar's husks stitched together in a red shell choker. Her cape is the iesina, a rare possession of years gone by, which belongs to her grandmother. The headdress, or tuinga, is formed out of human hair. Palefuyono, red and white feathers as hanging adornments, say, and polished pearl shells to replace the mirrors. She carries the nipooti that any taupo would carry when presenting a traditional offering and strutting in the village malai with pride as a Samoan fair maiden would on special occasions. Faluta's outfit was designed and created by Mrs. Julie Tuletufuma.
Federal Pacific Insurance. And our final contestant for this evening, contestant number 12, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss ANC.
Wear is decorated with red feathers. The manulele feathers were highly prized by the Samoans for decorating fine mats and the taupo's dancing costume. The skirt and train are made of fine mats representing the wealth of the Samoan family. The hair accessory is the tuinga, which is worn by the taupo only on very special occasions, such as entertaining dignitaries and weddings. The armband is made from the coconut shell. The coconut tree provided the Samoan family with food, drink, cleaning, and cooking materials, and was also used in construction of the whale. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss ANZ's traditional wear was designed and made by Jackie Loheni of Mena's Designs.
Thank you, Miss ANZ. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to bring back on stage all our contestants for a final look by our judges. Please put your hands together and welcome on stage all our contestants for a final look by our judges. se pati pati mai mo tatou tau salon le fiati e le fa linga o la tau la ei pa sa mo o le nei tau vanga
Yala
Another big round of applause for these beautiful young ladies. Thank you, ladies. And once again, thank you to all our sponsors for the beautiful prizes for the traditional wear and whoever may win it. Well, Dante, what's next on our program?
Well, Dan, our Tawila festivities and many other events that have taken place in the country have brought over many important people, one of which is a son of Samoa that needs no introduction. He is a former member of the Jamua Jam singing group, but he has gone solo and doing great with his career as a singer in New Zealand. It is even better that he is performing for us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Lapi Marina.
Salute, Lord, Paul, let me take you a little. se i fai mai sau pe sua inima pe sua imanu sau foga la upele sau sinai puvai malu se inu anea Otsamalenu,
come back on stage.
That's right, Dan.
And I would now like to call back on stage contestant number one, Miss Pineapple Enterprises, for her surround. In the surround category.
Is a depiction of Samoa's environment, which makes our Samoa the pride of Polynesia. The sarong is a one-piece material elegantly entwined around Miss Pineapple's body, comfortably for her to swim in. It displays a combination of tropical colors representing Samoa's blue seas, where the rich source of the nation's menu is found. Various sea creatures on Miss Pineapple's sarong were all hand-painted, reminiscent of some of Samoa's many legends. The flower on her hair also represents the bright and beautiful sunshine that Samoans are blessed to enjoy all year round. Miss Pineapple Sarong was designed by Gardenia Hinano Boutique and sewn by Mishi Pasi.
Thank you, Miss Pineapple Enterprises. Let's bring back on stage in her sarong, Miss Southern California.
Weeks of excitement here on the island, Valerie is now keen to show off, created and designed by her father, Steve Kelsall. A combination of blue-greenish colors, her sarong portrays the beautiful ocean of Samoa. You will find several sea creatures of the ocean airbrushed and hand-painted on her sarong, mostly Faisua, Fe'e, Pa'a, Tuitui, and Fumafunga, all of which classified as gourmet seafood of her Samoan people. The Tuitui and Fumafunga are the two most favorite seafoods of Valerie's grandparents hailing from Whangali'i and Bailele in the Waimaunga district. Her sarong is wrapped carefully to reveal her shape and curves, yet maintaining her modesty as a beauty of Samoa. Accentuating her sarong is a seashell necklace and anklets handpicked off the shores of Whangali'i and Bailele and some of the beaches in Apia. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Valerie Sina Kausal.
Thank you, Miss Samoa, Southern California. Please welcome on stage contestant number three, Miss Samoa Utah.
Maria Easter Tukmalo Yuelu Sarong are the sun rays of the universe. The tiare flowers are hand-printed on the fabric to bring out the colors of nature and its luscious environment. It's tied in a swimwear fashion, ideal for swimming in the blue lagoons of Samoa. Presenting Maria Easter in her swimwear sarong, appropriate for tonight's theme, the Pride of Polynesia.
Please welcome on stage contestant number four, Miss Samoa Australia from Brisbane.
Thank you, Miss Samoa Australia.
Luther Dean Sarong represents the fire from within, which typifies the pride of Samoa. Lightly printed on the flowing silk material are burning white flames, reminding us of the volcanic eruptions which dramatically changed the topography of Savai Island. The print also includes a lush fern, which signifies the importance of preserving the flora and fauna of our environment. The striking orangey-yellow colors also reflect the beautiful sunrises of Samoa, signifying new beginnings. The creativity of this design is work of Shima of Lux 2000.
Thank you, Miss Samoa Australia from Brisbane. Our next contestant is Miss McDonald's of Samoa.
The perception of sun and sea should not only be proclaimed, but we must also indulge ourselves in our beautiful moonlight nights and warm seas, as Robert Louis Stevenson, or Tusitala, as lovingly known to the Samoans, famously wrote, "Under the wide and starry sky." Our pristine marine environment, unspoilt and uncrowded beaches, have attracted many visitors to our shores. The natural beauty and our tropical climate have provided an experience of a lifetime. Just as Tusitala loved our tropical nights, Miss McDonald's is out to enjoy a swim in our warm South Pacific Ocean and to stargaze under the wide and starry sky. The fabric has been tied in a symmetrical design along the contours of her Samoan figure, displaying her natural tan, which so many around the world try to achieve. The starfish and shell accessories gathered from the marine accentuates the design and the fact that Samoa leads the Polynesian region with its natural beauty, delivering a true, authentic Pacific experience. It's no surprise Robert Louis Stevenson chose Samoa to spend the rest of his life. This unique swimwear was put together by Ruby Taituuma.
Thank you, Miss McDonald's Family Restaurant. Please welcome on stage contestant number 6 for New South Wales.
Osina Maletuna, one of Samoa's favorite legend, Rosina Sarong is dedicated to the legend of the coconut. A one-piece sarong creatively put together to reveal her natural beauty. Feeling very happy and confident with her natural Samoan figure, Rosina opted for the bright colors of Samoa to reveal her bubbly and outgoing personality. Her hat is made out of dried coconut leaves, while her belt is of shells, a reflection of land and water. The beautiful Samoan sun is simply shown through her never-ending smile. It is then adorned with a real coconut necklace to complete the theme of her sarong. Designed by Tito Schmidt Stowers of Lavash Designs, Sydney, Australia.
Thank you, Miss Samoa, New South Wales. Please welcome on stage contestant number 7, Miss Gionita Tours.
Representing her theme, ocean. Contestant number 7 is wrapped in an aqua-colored material decorated with images of one of our most precious and endangered species today, the turtle. The sarong paints a picture of the Wailaumei in Malua, which is the only nursery for the turtles in Samoa. She believes that turtles, or laumei, are one of the strong features of Samoan history. The net on her sarong describes a way in which turtles are captured and taken to the Wailaumei. Here, they are nurtured and secured until they are at a stage to be released into the ocean.
Thank you, Ms. Janita Tours. Please welcome on stage contestant number 8, Ms. Weddings of Samoa.
From generation to generation, the women of Samoa wear ielavalava as their everyday wear. Nelda's ielavalava is tied around her in a fashionable and modern style to suit her figure. Nelda has chosen a soft jersey material, cream in color, to complement the beautiful, clean, pristine, and sandy beaches as one of Samoa's most treasured attractions. The hand-painted illustration depicts the weira, Nelda Curry in the sea gathering shellfish with their ola basket made coconut leaves. The shellfish can be used to make Samoan jewelry. Her hat, Fulolo New, is also made out of coconut leaves to shade her face from the sun. After all the chores are done, she can take time to bathe in the sun and swim in the ocean. This attire reflects true Samoan pride with the jewel of its beaches and coral reef. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Weddings of Samoa, Miss Nelda Curry.
Thank you, Miss Weddings of Samoa. Please welcome on stage contestant number 9, Miss Molesi Samoa Limited.
Ofusina thinks that a sarong should be simple, practical, and attractive. Having this in mind, her sarong is simply simple. The tie is just from her right arm down her belly, then her lava lava with a split to show a bit of her skin for a tan. The bright colors she has chosen is mainly for attractiveness. While she relaxes and swims to forget the hard work of the week she had gone through.
Thank you, Miss Molesi Samoa Limited. Please welcome on stage contestant number 10, Miss Samoa New Zealand.
Marilina's sarong is bright, sophisticated, and comfortable for a good swim and a day at the beach. Tied strategically to enhance her typical island curves, Marilina's sarong is her modernized interpretation of a conservative Samoan ie'au'au. The bright orange material depicts the sunrise and sunset of Samoa, the pride of Polynesia. To complement her sarong, Marilina is wearing white and yellow ulasisi shells knitted from the beach. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Samoa, New Zealand.
Miss Samoa, New Zealand, please welcome on stage contestant number 11, Miss Federal Pacific Insurance.
When heading down to the cool, crystal clear waters of the exotic shores of our Samoa, Falute prefers to be free, bright, simple, trendy, yet elegant. This is her look tonight with flowers adorning her hair, enhancing her island and Polynesian beauty. It is tied in a very simple way, allowing her flexibility when swimming. Accessorizing her sarong or lava lava is a netting basket made of tawanga adorned with seashells. Arriving at the beach, Falute flicks out her towel. Sits down and applies her coconut oil to catch that tan. Is ready to soak up the sun. After a few hours, it's time to head home. Falute Sarong is designed and created by Mrs. Leata Talai Paul.
Yeah. Pacific Insurance. And our final contestant for this evening, contestant number 12, Miss ANC.
As you can see, Sally Sarong is black and white. Black represents Samoa before Christianity was introduced to the Samoan people. White represents the arrival of the missionaries in Samoa. The sarong design is of grapefruit leaves with a malu design. The malu is a tattoo which was done only on taupos and daughters of high chiefs. Sally carries a handbag made from the grapefruit or ulu leaf, and the bark is used for handles. Her headpiece is fashioned to match the design on her design, thus completing her outfit designed by Ernie Tuala.
Thank you, Miss ANC. This is your best
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I believe the girls deserve another round of applause for the creativity in the design and presentation of their sarong. I'm pretty sure the audience, especially the judges, would like to see the girls once more in this category. So let's give a hand for the contestants as they parade for the judges' final look. Ladies.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on stage Miss Pineapple Enterprises and Miss Southern California. Receive a total prize of 800 tala.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Samoa, Utah, and Miss Samoa, Australia, Brisbane. Musica Malie.
McDonald's of Samoa and Miss Samoa New South Wales.
Weddings of Samoa.
Finally, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Federal Pacific Insurance and Miss ANC. Correction, is Miss Polesi Samoa and Miss Samoa New Zealand. Metro Pacific Insurance and Miss ANC. Please welcome on stage Miss Molesi Samoa and Miss Samoa New Zealand. How about another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for our 12 contestants as they conclude another segment of this competition. Thank you, ladies. Well, I'm Dante. I think the girls are now ready to perform their talents this evening.
That's right, Dan.
And without further ado, I would now like to call on stage contestant number one for her talent this evening.
La Mauta is going to perform for us how a Fautasi is captained in the annual Fautasi competition that takes place during independence celebration as well as the Te Wila festival. It is one of the highlights of these national celebrations. Winning the competition depends on a combination of things, the strength and fitness of the rowers, but importantly are the skills of the captain in directing the different rowing styles used in winning this race. Ladies and gentlemen, La Mauta Simanu with her talent.
Makua, kualu kaku foi, paoso babe, simar kaku fakingi, saungi.
Aloha, Taila Mauta. The Kaubaya is a captain, ya itala uva maula uva bato na lo sam.
Talo vaisi awolo ba aden.
Thank you, Lamauta, for that demonstration on how to captain a Fautasi in the annual Fautasi competition. And moving along our program this evening, I would now like to call back on stage contestant number two, Miss Samoa Southern California, for her talent.
Robert Louis Stevenson was an outsider who happened to arrive in Samoa and fell in love with Samoa and overcome by the spirit of our people. The famous author became known to the Samoan people as a teller of tales in Samoan Tangata Tustala. He was later raised on top of Mount Vaia as his final resting place, and a verse from his poem Requiem is engraved on his tombstone, in which Valerie will sing and finally perform a knife dance in his honor. Valerie's pulutasi is white with Te Wila prints, while showing her respect for the dead, and the Te Wila print symbolizes our celebration of such festival and also the main flowers surrounding Robert Louis Stevenson's graveside. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Samoa, Southern California, Valerie Sina Castle with her talent.
Samoa, Southern California, for your talent. Please welcome on stage Miss Samoa Utah for her talent.
Easter grew up in Hawaii and has always loved music and dancing. Her talent displays that by the medley songs of Hawaii, Tahiti, and Samoa, which she has embraced and danced to their rhythms and tempo. Easter is very proud of her Samoan heritage, which has prepared her well for this category.
Samoa, you time for your talent. Now I'd like to call back on stage contestant number 4, Miss Samoa Australia from Brisbane, for your talent this evening.
Toi sa saale pa fau Samoa, ma toi te patasi I le vavau. O au mea sina nei, wata wau I na ngalo atu. O le whaingale nei, o nisi o ia a Samoa. Sai mai le fau ma vavalu, fa'ala ia mango. A mango to tosi ni a tingi fifi ma le langa. Ona ave lea ta I le sami, a maea ta I le vai. E fape a lava ona ta I le sami ma le vai se ia fai fai. A fai la le fau, sa lo le lei lalo se ia mua moi fa lei. E fa ie e ma fai ona fai ai nei ie. Fa lanu e ma fai ona fai ai nei ie. Ie fai pae o le ie sina. Ie oli uli o le ie fui pani. Ia ena ena o le ia fau. ma o le ia lona fa o le fainga lenei. E palu le ele mumu i le vai i te tono le tā noa. Fufui i ai me whaata ele le ie. Ona ave lea whaala te ia mango le lei. O fōlinga nei o le ia mumu, po le ia tā ele. Ma o ngā luenga ia a le tamaitai. Tamaitai, from humble beginnings you come, and from humble beginnings you shall return. Tamaitai, have you forgotten who you are? Crown yourself. Title to mean the back of the house. Instead, understand who you are. You are the structure of the house, the heart of the ainga. Understand who you are. You are the rib from the side of the head, made equal for success with equal opportunity. You are the bearer of the nations with power to empower. Understand who you are. You are the sweet aroma of the island, by the stove or on your breast. You have been called for great things, unseen, unheard, unspoken. Your beauty is not from lipstick, nor eyeshadow, nor ornament. Your beauty is that which lies deep within. Your internal makeup, your internal heartbeat, your internal you. Keep yourself wrapped in your humble beginnings and crowned with the truth of who you are, and continue to dance to the beat of your own heart. Faletua, tau sala o Samoa, is true inner beauty. From humble beginnings I came, and from humble beginnings I shall return.
Thank you, Miss Samoa, Australia, from Brisbane. Please welcome on stage Miss McDonald's Family Restaurant, for her talent this evening.
Jennifer's talent tonight, ladies and gentlemen, will demonstrate the importance and her role as a true Samoan woman in our society. She will also demonstrate her talent through singing.
Thank you.
Hello, Pad Thai. Pad Thai is McDonald's family restaurant. I would now like to call on stage contestant number 6, Miss Moa New South Wales, for her talent this evening.
Samoa is the pride of the Pacific, the identity of our islands that we have kept central from generation to generation. Through our legends and myths before, the luxury of a pen and paper, our people kept a hall of records through the word of mouth. With the high maintenance of storytelling, tonight, Rosina will take you on a timeline tour in the time when our elders told the myths and legends to the youth. Ladies and gentlemen, Rosina and her accolade to the ancestors.
Makua! Makua!
Wow, Nema!
So. Sao su ai me lau kapa apo feo yai. Sao sei fofola mai ngai fala sei wasau fole po.
Se.
E ke se mai ya. Sao la. Sao lo vai oe. Moi la ya. Moi la.
Se. Pa fa mole kaka la anga po.
We e vi ya le le. E ke fa lo nga ka anga fo we fa lo se fa ngong. Ya. Ole ala le menga nga ka kaka la nga po.
Ke mi lenga. Kai mi lenga kawai na fanoma kama.
Ya oi, ya ba makal kau. Sa fai lo ma vai nga nga fanua mo nga ma ko kausi. O mama o makunga mama kunga. Ya fai ko ele ke nga fanua. Kamaika. Aua le feso poai ala. Ya, I think wa o vale fie lo ma le fie malo losio matuna ma matu wa ia la so po ia ile ala tawol te mai ta ia ma wa fa o mati ai ila ua ile uli masao ale te mai ta sunga e o ile a wa e moi
ne ai ma
e ia ala la kala fai
oi ave
o le tau ele nu o fai a ai. Wa keke le a kama, wa kele kama, wa male leo ele ua kongi al kamai ka. Ai ilunga la al kamai ma ke ele ngai fai a ai. O inga ngai lua ai ele au kau. O na fanua, o le tamai ta. Ina ua le lea ese, le ufi ufi fata fata o le tamai ta. Ia, ai kau kwa kau ma, oi ia, 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 ai fai, ia, eni, lea ila. Ngala wa mama ai lua kama. So solo lo kamo wale ai mase se ko fi kau ongo le kenge la la ke kau e o ka ikai ba magiki te o ka kingo
ama
ma magiki o kingo
ai se a
e bo so foi lo fi asi le kau le kenge
ma
Miss Moa New South Wales, thank you for your talent this evening. I like your style. Okay, we have now come to contestant number 7, Miss Tionita Tours, for her talent this evening.
Tonight, Shirley will be using her music background to express a significant aspect she has experienced since her move to a life in Samoa.
Samoa is a land where unspoiled cultures and natural wonders still exist.
It was the first Pacific Island nation to gain independence in 1962. Since then, Samoa portrays one of the most unique features in the South Pacific. Every morning from Monday to Friday, Apia, the capital, come to life with a police parade, stopping all the passing traffic as they parade through the main street towards the government building to raise the flag of freedom. The three most important aspects of this unique feature I have observed are respect, honor, and pride.
Talofa lava Samoa, ole foi wa tato mo mai le nei tai o matu fi, fa o popo i loto soi fua, ma se matu o la vai vai. I ia la le alofa o le atua i lo nanga lei, ma o le taimi fo nei, ua toi se funu minute o na tale o le itu la e balu, ma ua fa pe o nanga i atua le malure.
Multi-talented, I must say.
Yes, a very talented lady, sponsored by Miss Janita Tours. Thank you, Shirley, for that beautiful talent. And I would now like to call back on stage contestant number 8, Miss Weddings of Samoa, for her talent.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nelda's talent is a Samoan speech relating to the theme, Samoa, the Pride of Polynesia.
E peo le fetalainga tautai. O maka tautai foi le alio li. E peo tala le baso loa. O aso fa pene. E le eise sa moe fa fia potu ai. A wafai tautala le afiafia mana ia. O nou fa pea lea. O asungalo le po. A wau tsele le po ulo a waluma. A wau pa ia sa moe wa umon to fi to fa ia inga maala tau tama. Tama foi maola tau a inga. A wau I have fight so tall, you lulu, Belman Vassolo, Lova Bellia, Womalu to all before Malu, a wow bowl of Fatu, of Bongi for Ivan. I'll love your pie by your tamba, tell what to toil ever. Pay tie lota tota, I have the Luna Luale, nay. Oh, my ala lofala tota tota ever man aluai, a wow, a wow, sir, more with our violia tua. I'll love your pie by your tamba, tell what to toil ever. I tell it I out, I lay out I out. I tell it for po, I lay out po. I out and boy boy, I lord po, lulu latino. One day, what's all in my natua? So I told my vine, I love for natua, so if you are.
After Miss Weddings of Samoa, and Dante, I must say that's a very difficult talent, public speaking.
That's right, Dan.
Anyway, I would like to call back on stage contestant number 9, Miss Molesi Samoa Limited, for her talent this evening.
For her talent, Ofusina moves to express the time the Mau movement took place in Samoa. The Mau was simply for the opinions of the Samoans to be voiced and heard, simply seeking independence, freedom, and peace. Brave Letama Aino, Tupua Tamasese Meaone, was assassinated during this time. Tonight, Sina acts out the move by the people of the Mau in a form of creative dance. Dedicates her graceful Siva Samoa to those who died, those who dream for independence, freedom, and a peaceful Samoa. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Samoa, the pride of Polynesia.
I would now like to call on stage contestant number 10, Miss Simone Mselin, to perform her talent.
Marilina's talent is a reenactment of a moment in history, taking us back to some of the difficult times our nation encountered. So Samoa, the pride of Polynesia, did not go through smooth sailing. But what is important is how we rise above these difficulties and still stand proud today.
In the early 1900s, Samoa was in the Sa'ili Malo era, a time of change with the influx of foreign invaders. But Samoa was not prepared for one particular invasion. Leprosy, lepela. Even the New Zealand administration governing Samoa at the time could not manage the contagious spread of the deadly epidemic. Thousands were exiled in a desperate attempt for control. Tonight, Marilena mourns for her loved ones who were banished in shiploads to the Fiji Islands of Makonai, a leper colony for those awaiting death. A lone figure on the dots of the wharf, Marilena yearns, wishing she had wings like a dove, so she could fly, fly to her loved ones.
My Ocelong of Ailo Su Eane Sa Iliane Sia Upele Awe Musue Etu. Tapia
Thank you, Miss Samoa, New Zealand. I would now like to call upon contestant number 11, Miss Federal Pacific Insurance, for her talent this evening.
Faluta's talent is about how men and women of the past have shaped the course of our future as we now know of it. Faluta's tribute in form of dance pays homage to the greatest contribution to Samoa, the coming of Christianity.
Nafanua was one of Samoa's greatest warriors. She was goddess of war, given the highest honor in her time known as Au, or mana, by her people of Aesifo. Her mana increased considerably. Her authority over the realm consolidated. She became ruler over the land. All powers were unified under her. She gave these to others like Salamasina, the first queen of Samoa, or the Tefaifa. Malietoa went to Nafanua in search of a prophecy as to the future. She responded that he had come too late, as all the kingdoms have been given away. But he should wait, for his kingdom will come from heaven. There was unrest and civil wars amongst the Ainas at the time. There was bloodshed and political upheavals everywhere as the search for a ruler continued. Divine intervention arrived in 1830. A ship called Savali Orfilemu, or messenger of peace at Mataan, Yufengai Malata and Sapali Savai, brought the answer to Maliator's request. Missionaries brought the good news of God. This was the kingdom that Nafanua promised to Maliator. It was the coming of Christianity. This was the turning point for all Samoans, as the kingdom from heaven had finally arrived. Ending political unrest and wars, it marked the birth of a new era, the time when God was accepted as the supreme authority over Samoa. In 1962, Samoa became independent, and its coat of arms reflects these words: Samoa is founded on God. It is a solid foundation holding Samoa together. It protects our heritage, our culture, our beliefs, and it makes us realize who we are. Our coat of arms is forever symbolized in the Akrava ceremony, welcoming Yohane Viliamu, when Maliator said, "Water have become bitter, but the Ava drink that was once bitter to the taste is sweetened through God's love." For this kingly ritual is cause for celebration, and is signified by the clapping of our hands, as the Ava of the old covenant is transformed to symbolize that of the new. Waina mai, au mahalo Ava ile alofo ole tua, awa o lea wa patipati ai, atauta ole atua malona fina mai. Ma wani ua ai, Ava ole fengai atua ai, ifai ma Ava ole fengai ufo. God is blessing this land because Samoa is founded on God.
Thank you, Ms. Federal Pacific Insurance, for your talent this evening. And our final contestant, contestant number 12, to perform her talent, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. ANC.
Come on.
Thank you, Miss ANC, for your talent. Ladies and gentlemen, as you have seen this evening, our contestants are not only beautiful, but full of talent and creativity.
That's right, Dan. The next category, ladies and gentlemen, the contestants will showcase various designs of another form of traditional wear since Samoa became independent, and that is the puletasi.
Yes, there will be a special award for the puletasi, the best puletasi. As but reminding you, ladies and gentlemen, that this doesn't count towards the overall score of the night. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage contestant number one, Miss Pineapple Enterprises, in her puletasi.
Miss Pineapple's puletasi is a three-piece outfit. The pink overlap portion represents the fresh looks of a young Polynesian girl at the turning point of becoming a beautiful woman. The bottom edge of the overlap is splashed with black and glitter with silver to match the inside of the puletasi that is now revealed when the overlap is removed. La Mauta is wearing a sleek and elegant one-sleeve, two-toned puletasi. The pink leaves adorned with gold pippin cord with the insides of leaves splashed with black and silver glitter to enhance more the looks of her puletasi. Crawling up to her left shoulder represents the links of the Polynesian group of islands coming in unity and sharing a common culture that is unique in the Pacific. Miss Pineapple is delighted to display her puletasi that can be worn to various occasions designed by Gardenia Hinano Boutique and put together by Mishi Pasi.
Thank you, Miss Pineapple Enterprises. Please welcome on stage contestant number two, Miss Moa Southern California.
Valerie Sina Council has chosen the color black as a color of beauty, of strength. She believes the beauty of a Samoan young lady is the most dominant in all aspects of her young life, and she would need all the strength to carry her through, especially that of the Almighty. The rich black satin material depicting our rich culture and how full of life it has become. Mother of pearls placed on various parts of her puletasi is a constant reminder to us all that Samoa is not only the heart of Polynesia, but indeed the pearl of the Pacific. An opening on the side of her puletasi made out of coconut and mother of pearls reveals Valerie's ladylike figure, the beauty of a Samoan lady. The top of her puletasi features a snake-like neck accentuated by mother of pearls or tifa. The neck of her puletasi is that of a viper that devours all the bad that might attack and influence our young people of today. It also represents our awareness to be alert at all times, in all things, and in all places as we Samoan ladies strive to become better in all that we do. A flower bed in her hair acknowledges the beauty of Mother Nature and how influential it can become if we but take the time to listen and learn. Valerie's puletasi was designed and created by Francis Nickel of Nickel Touch in California.
Thank you, Miss Moa Southern California. Please welcome on stage contestant number three, Miss Moa Utah.
Samoa Utah's puletasi wear is a tribute to her beliefs. Her puletasi is made out of white linen, representing her belief in her Heavenly Father. White represents faith. Her faith in God is a solid foundation of who she is. White also represents purity. As Samoan ladies, we should be pure in heart and in mind. Hand-painted on the lower part of her puletasi is a taupo, and on the top part is a ulanifo and a taulima. These represent her belief of our Samoan culture. A culture based on love and respect for all. A culture founded on God, our Creator.
Thank you,
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Samoa Utah and her Kulata Siwea.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring on stage contestant number 4, Miss Samoa Australia from Brisbane.
Bertha Dean's Pulitasi signifies the purity of our islands and unique traditions of Samoa. The color of her Pulitasi reflects the beautiful sandy beaches of our shores. The wavy design on the sinnet reflects the vast ocean that unifies the islands of the Pacific. These islands are represented by the coconut shells. Deeply rooted in Samoa's traditions is the authority and respect for the talking chief. The fui that lies on the shoulder of the Samoan talking chief is represented here by the sinnet which hangs from the shoulder of Bertha Dean's Pulitasi. Today, many women are also taking up the role of talking chief within Samoan families. Ladies and gentlemen, Bertha Dean's Pulitasi has been designed and created by Shima of Lux 2000.
Thank you, Miss Samoa Australia from Brisbane. Please welcome on stage contestant number 5, Ms. McDonald's Family Restaurant.
Samoa, also known as the heart of Polynesia through anthropology and archaeological studies, concludes that Samoa populated all the islands from as far as Hawaii down to New Zealand and Easter Island. Amongst all these islands is a common legend of Tangalolangi, the god of heaven, which before 1830 was Samoa's belief as well. The vibrant black fabric portrays this era of pre-Christianity. As a God-fearing nation, the transition from the Dark Ages to Christianity was amazingly without any bloodshed or transgression. The story tells of a new god approaching, so when the light-skinned missionary arrived, the Samoans thought he was sent from heaven as anticipated. Thus, the descending white Ele prints represented the arrival of the missionary from the heavens to our islands. At that time, as Samoa was still very much naive with this new religion, they had presumed this new god was sent by Tangalolangi and therefore named this missionary Papalangi, as they were certain the missionary broke away from the sky. Funny enough, the missionary was fair-skinned, so all the fair-skinned people they saw after that was automatically called Apalangi. So the term for the fair-skinned person is not a derivative from the English language, but is something that is in our culture and language. We Samoans take pride in knowing that our forefathers accept the Spirit of the Lord without any bloodshed as compared to other islands who engaged in cannibalism with the missionaries. A design by Ruby Tetuuma.
Thank you, Ms. McDonald's Family Restaurant. Please welcome on stage contestant number 6, Miss Samoa New South Wales.
Momoe Malietoa Von Raiki motivates the idea for Rosina's Pulitasi. As one of Samoa's finest artists, the designer of Rosina's Pulitasi tonight was one of Momoe's ex-students in art. Therefore, Rosina's Pulitasi is a fine piece of contemporary art. A celebration of different culture, Rosina's Pulitasi shows her love of her native Samoa and adopted home, Australia. Champagne in color, it reflects Christianity, peace, love, and harmony. It is then adorned with tapa as a reminder of what we used to wear in the old days. Finally, the coconut shells complete her Pulitasi as a celebration of various cultures and religions uniting into one. This Pulitasi was designed and put together by Tito Schmidt Stowers of Lavash Designs, Sydney, Australia.
Thank you, Ms. Samoa New South Wales. I would now like to introduce to you contestant number 7, Ms. Jonita Tours in her Pulitasi.